Hi everyone. Ants are all over my garden. The heat we've had recently here in Southern California has brought them in droves. So today I'm going to share with you a really easy DIY ant trap using simple household ingredients so that you can control them in your garden too. Now, if you just have a few ants in your garden, that's usually not a problem. But when they come in large numbers, that can be an issue because where there are ants, there are usually aphids. Now, ants and aphids work as a team in the garden, which is not necessarily a good thing. You can see on this cucumber plant here, there's a ton of aphids and there's also a lot of ants trailing into the plant. So what happens is the aphids secrete a sugary substance which attracts the ants, and then the ants in turn protect the aphids from pests and predators. But ants are relatively easy to control with my simple DIY ant trap. So let me show you how it's made. We're going to make our DIY ant traps with three ingredients. It's very simple and you may already have these around your house. The first component is sugar. Sugar is what is going to attract the ants to your bait stations. And the second ingredient here is borax. This particular brand of borax is a natural mineral, contains sodium tetraborate. So it is an organic substance. And then we're going to use water to help make a sticky paste. Now borax can be used as a cleaning product or a laundry booster, and you can usually find it at your local drugstore. So we're going to combine these in a ratio of 3 to 1. We're going to use 1 cup sugar and 1/3 cup of borax. And you don't want to get too much borax in your ant traps because then the ants can smell it and they won't be attracted to it. But the borax is a component that's going to help control your ant population. And what borax does is it disrupts the life cycle of the ants and it kills them slowly. They'll take it back to their nest and share it with the colony and the queen. And the slow control of the ant population is really key because you want them to take it back to their nest and share it with the rest of the colony so that the colony goes away. So here I'm just combining the sugar and the borax and I'm trying to mash up any chunks that might be in there. Actually, I'm gonna use this spoon here. I think that might work a little better. I'm just gonna mix it up. And here I have an organic raw sugar, but you can definitely use a white processed sugar if that's what you have on hand. You can definitely make it in a smaller quantity, but you want to have a 1-to-3 ratio, 3 parts sugar to 1 part borax. So now what I'm going to do is make like a sticky paste, adding my water. Now you want to add the water slowly because you want to make a paste. You want it to be nice and thick. You don't want it to be too runny. So just add the water gradually, then mix it up a little bit at a time. So my water borax mixture is looking like a nice little sticky paste. And it will thicken a little bit as it stands, but this is looking pretty good right now. So now what I'm going to do is make my traps. And I just cut apart little pieces of cardboard for this. We're going to spread this sticky substance on the cardboard. You could also use yogurt lids, cut off the bottom of water bottles, but ideally you want your little sticky traps to be as flat as possible to make it as easy as possible for the ants to climb on. So I'm just putting a teaspoon or so on each, kind of spreading it around. And you do want to make sure when you place your traps, you keep them out of reach of your children or your pets, because it can be toxic to them. Now, just a little note about what you use for your sticky trap. If you can, find something flat. I do like to use cardboard because it's disposable, because these do tend to harden up, and that way you can throw them right in the trash when you're done with them. Now, on the placement of the traps. Again, don't put them somewhere where your kids or your pets can get to them. So rather than placing it right on the edge of the garden bed here where Matt could get to it, I'm going to actually stick them right inside, and you definitely want to find a location where there is a little ant trail. So here this ant trail goes right down inside the garden bed. The ants are crawling right down here, so I'm just going to stick them right next to there. And look, you can see a little ant is already crawling right on it. So what they do is they take some of that, take it back to their nest, and share it with the rest of the colony. I'm going to stick these kind of throughout the garden bed here. I every foot or so. You know, there's no exact science to it, but you definitely want to place them where the ants are. Now, there are ants covering this okra plant. I'm going to place some right at the bottom. There's some ants crawling around in here. I don't know if that you're going to pick that up on camera, but I'm going to place it right down at the bottom of the okra plant, and then the ant should consume that bait before they climb up the okra. Now, if a little bit drips into the soil, it's no big deal. It is an organic substance. There are just ants everywhere along the inside of this garden bed here. So I'm going to actually place them about every foot or so. And this will really help control the ant population. After about a half hour or an hour or so, you should see a few ants in your sticky traps there. You're not going to see it covered in ants because the ants, again, grab the bait and take it back to their nest. Now, as with most organic methods of pest control, it's not a one and done solution. So you will have to go in every couple of weeks and replace these traps, and don't expect it to be immediately effective. It does take place over time. But remember, just like with the spider mites, anything is better than nothing, and you win some and you lose some, but will definitely help control the ant population in your garden. Well, comment below if you're gonna use the DIY ant traps in your garden. Let me know how it works for you. And also make sure you check out my seed shop at CallieKimGardeningHome.com, 20 seed collections, and my book, Organic Gardening for Everyone, to help you grow more vegetables. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.